Morning. I'm going to work a little bit on the policy. Let's start by logging in. Where it's 8 o'clock in the morning, 12 past 8 to be exact. Let's see, 8, 12, and obviously there's still a lot of work to be done. Say the least. Let's have a look and see. So let's add some obvious stuff and actually I'm thinking about actually confining the exec session because, to be honest, it doesn't have to be that attribute. It doesn't have to be running in the user domain. Oops. I need to stop making these typos, obviously. Set D needs to get attribute of cache home tedious. So it seems that all these programs need that, but this doesn't show up right away. this takes a long time. Need to also take my time to just take, yeah, to just do this. Try to enjoy it. There's no rush. I'm not in a rush to make this work. So we have Canberra. That's not what we need. So I will should just focus on transitions right about now. Because we can basically deal with the remainder in a much more easier way. But we have TR store stuff. Oh, these are, should go up here. And these should go. This one is also obvious. The XDG user update. this will take a long time anyways. Believe you me. Hopefully this will be easily portable to Fedora 19. Because Fedora 19 is not far from being released. So let's have a look at grab execute. Yes. So, GNOME 16 of GNOME Shell actually creates files in temp and executes them and maps them. Let's have a look at where. We can figure out a path. Yeah. So let's try and do that in this run. Okay, so now I'm in this stuff again, but this time I know what to do. Control A, Control X, basically. So let's just carve this on the my error sheet. I just basically for some reason decided not to do this. Is the reason is that I can't do it. I just can't do it. I wish I could, but I can't. So let's just remove that. Now I start to think about it and I just figure that that's just not possible because this is done using setExec. And I could override it, but then I'd override it for others as well, because it's actually TDM executing it. So it's unfortunate, but it's not possible. So let's just go on and with our little exercise. So create. Let's have a look at our and this can be removed by now actually. Let's just have a look. I can't do it like that. Add all that. Home. My login. We need to just proceed. It's that just that simple. So let's have a look at cache, how cache currently looks. And cache looks good currently. It looks damn near perfect. Now let's look at config, what's in there. So config is currently still labeled with a default type, and do we have a trail? No, we don't have a trail yet of it creating. Let's have a look at local share. So let's do grep for gconf, because this stuff is created by default. So we need to work on this, I think. So let's look. We have this now, this stuff that we need to confine. And what do we have? Non Q and Gaming is now in the tracker store. That sucks. Telepathy, we have telepathy here, and it's created by TPMC, so we need to take care of that. So let's not copy this over, or actually this one. Config or local share, local share, and then telepathy. Telepathy, and then I'll call this TPMC, TPMC data home key. And actually, I can't. Let's have a look. LSR local share rep telepathy. So we need to basically, yeah, data home key. So telepathy data home key. So I need to basically use that, else, and I can't use the file context spec either. So where is TPMC? It's early, and then you know how that goes when it's early. So, require telepathy data home NT, and then there's still a lot more, because we need to do data first. Messy, 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 messy indeed. And data is not. Okay, then I guess it's going to be temp. Then it's going to be temp. G shell. I know G shell is creating a file, so that's one thing I can do. So let's just do that. Type G shell temp T, and it's a it's both a file type. There's also a temp file type, and it's a user temp type, and then basically to take out this type transition shell, it's empty, and then it's a file actually, d shell empty, and we can't use a name because it's a random name, and then basically allow, and we'll start with the simple stuff, empty, in there, and then write app name, but it's also going to have to remove, pretty sure about that, and then just copy this and then make that for file create, t shell empty. Okay, so that should take care of that file. Let's see what else we have for temp, because we can't still can't deal with this stuff here because I don't know what creates config there or the share there either or. Grab temp t grab create. This is the deconfigure in user run. This is that this is that gnome shell file. So we need to just work through this list. This deconfigure, the first one that we're going to do, the first one is deconf, and inside the deconf there, I think, will be that user file. So we need to wait with that. And then we have this tracker store in tempt, which basically is, we can basically do tracker store is creating stuff in temp. It should be basically let's just go ahead with doing deconf first and use the temp to, and it's getting created by imsetd. So where is imsetd? Let's create a new type, and I'll just call this type deconf temp, because this needs to be created by various needs to be able to be created by various domains. This is this unhack basically, this use of temp stuff for Dandelion, but well, we have to basically integrate so that should take care of that. On to the next. And it's not that user file, because that user file actually actually done by is a file inside that deconfder. But this one, for example, is a random bit, but in a generic temp directory, so we can basically stick there and call this one inset d temp d. So we need to go up. Actually, let's just adjust this. Need to take your time and do it, and then just basically create a new type. Let's take care of that. Then we have tracker store also creating a file in temp. TR store. Where is TR store? TR store temp3 type attribute TR store temp3 file type, and then copy that over a couple times. Classify this as a temp file. Just basically add that in. Type transition. And let's actually check a store creating that file in temp. Temp t store temp. See, and it's actually a file, yeah, but we can't actually use the main file transition. Allow temp t dir, right, and add name. And then just copy that over for create a file with type dir store temp t. Create file. DR store empty. Let's go back to imsetd. Then let's see if that imsetd is done properly. Because this was also a file, so I did that wrong. This inset is a file. Good thing I looked that up. And that is user, we don't have to do that. We did the GNOME shell, and then we have here some stuff that DOA daemon. Creates a new user temp there, but we don't know what it is yet. So I guess it might be a good idea to just try and build this right now, because it's early and it's my first run, so it'll help me a bit, probably, hopefully. See, we need to all this required here. Says sometimes these requires need to be doubled or something. Require attribute temp file. Because I would have sworn I already required this earlier, but somehow same for the user temp type. Somehow that doesn't catch it. User temp type. Because it's lower. That with the shell temp see a lot of bugs. A lot of early morning typos. because my head is still in my ass. E9 2254. Now it builds. Again, you need to take your time. This is not something you can rush. And again, you'll panic because you see all the stuff that you need to do. So you have something like, oh, I wanna hurry. But that's not a good idea. And now we also have this network manager applet coming up, so we have some new stuff. And it's 8:55, so let's have a look at the ABC denials, but then just I will to allow them a lesson. Let's see what else popped up. Something probably ran into. Can't really see it right now. What? But I guess there should be an package kit applet. But anyway, let's just kill all and then clear the. Clear my user and then as all that temp remove pulse audio. Now as all run user and that there is nicely removed. Nice. So that actually gets removed if you when you log out. That's cool. Let's do an out search and see what we have at 57. Nothing. Let's log in. Look at this again. See, now we have deconf temp t here. We should have a look at the deconf file. Let's just do this on my main rig. LSR C run user deconf. If it's only that simple user file, oh, and that's 1000. See, it's only that user file, so we can just keep that deconf empty. So that makes it easier for us. We can just allow all this stuff, this deconf stuff. So I'll first do go through the list. A B R T Apple. Abort applet, and it's actually searching cache-hunt2, wasn't it? Just to be sure. Yeah. So add that. And then we have etsp creating the user file. Then we have deconf actually also doing the stuff in deconf empty. And is there anything related to that? Not yet, but let's also allow it this one. They are Dipmon, yeah, they all want access to that deconf file. And yeah, it's probably going to need this Dina Segmon. Allow this to be in a second. DNS segment. Back. We have evo address factory. Evo address. And it also wants to get attributes of home root T. also wants that stuff, that decon stuff, they all want it. So we can basically at some point create a Evo edit. Actually, but I'm Evo align. Evo align. And I'm pretty sure it also wants to basically get attributes of humility. These are things that they all need. And then Evo Tel Factory. Also wants to Evo Tel. This is in the wrong, oh no, that's not in the wrong place. Place it in there. And then here, it also wants humility. We're steadily trying to solve things, but we're trying to do it without assuming, or at least as much as we're trying to assume as little as possible. This is Evo source register. Evo source reg. I need to move this. Make it a little bit more organized. Organize it a little bit. Then we have this fuse amount, which is actually will actually disallow that. Fuser. It's a little bit ugly, this temp D stuff, but there's not much we can do about it. Decom source search provider. Decom search P. And then also wants Gdoc search provider. Gdoc search P. That's not it though. J console. this is then related to the parent. Now keyring diamond. Move this below. This one. Session. For num session, I'm going to add these two. I'm just going to look that up manually, because you know how num session, how hard it is to find that using the control W. Because it got its thanks in everything. This basically, we could basically add this already as well. If we use handwriting. Because it wants to traverse it, that's pretty obvious. And you can see it here as well. Deconf data convert. Dset data convert. Dset data convert. Don't see much of that often. So here we have this one, and we need to get attribute for homewood T. But we also need to get attribute for user temp T. Shell assumptions basically listing them. Now what I'm going to do is grab G shell. T, and then grab tempty, see if it's actually tempty, but it's probably it, should be it. Yeah, it's actually tempty. So we can add that for GNOME shell. Here, read and remove. She's basically trying to remove that entry. Here. Oops. I'll just do it like that. See what else we have. User home the T, read good attribute. Open, yeah. User temp T, yeah, once you get attribute there, obviously. Let's see what I do. Both. Or to this one actually. Now multi, I'm pretty sure that it also wants to basically search and get attributes of user and guilty. G shell calendar. Basically everyone who wants to go to a deconf wants to also get attribute of user empty. So GNOME shell calendar daemon. G shell cal d. Just at points like this you're really at some point wondering what the hell you're doing, and basically you get the tendency to actually just stop because there's so much stuff and keeps going and going. You'll start to think or start to question whether it's actually worth it. Okay, I'm messing up. You start to wonder whether it's worth all this stuff, and especially if you're doing this raw, it's taking you even longer. DFS fuser. DVFSB fuzzy. So here we have the deconf startling. Let's just do this a little bit more careful. Let's just first take care of the deconf stuff. So deconf dir right open. Actually dir is get attribute. And this is actually network manager applet. What the fuck am I doing? Looking in the wrong place. Stay sharp. There. It's actually creating that user file in that deconf dir. Then it's actually creating the user file. Attempt to remove name. Obviously it also wants to get attribute. A search. How else can you get there? Let's also allow it to get attribute to the first. Let's actually file. Then use attempt to get attribute, yeah. But I already took care of that. So now it's Nautilus. Let's just allow this one to get attributes and let's eventually also search homotif. And also get attributes. Use attempt to It sucks that these are empty stuff, but there's not much we can do about it. Network manager applet. Same deal here. Now this one will add a home with this get attribute. And here we also add a user temp get attribute. List temp for some reason. Skip that for now. Ignore all this stuff for now. TPMC. TPMC. Use it empty. Here we have a get attribute of humble. We have a TPMC, tempty, listen, tempty, get an attribute, we have that, check minor effects, TR minor effects. Of course it wants us also to search. Wants to get attribute SSH MD for whatever reason. But since that is has a private type, because you can just allow that. Then we have checker store, lol stuff, a lot of stuff, so let's just move there, TR store, and then just take it one step at a time. So we have this cache, get attribute cache. That's the first get attribute. Next we have the decon stuff, and then also use a temp to get attribute. And then we have some stuff in temp. We need to remove. also have get attribute using her ability. And then we have also stuff with regard to cache more. Cache, home the search. And then also TR store. Write and link file. These not yet. Let's see if we have no still Debus messages. No. Right. We do have here this one, so let's just take out that. Okay, let's see if this builds. Take it one small steps. Small steps. Log out. Clear stuff. Kill the first let's kill. Clear stuff. And it's 9. This looks all fine. This is stuff that we still need to deal with. Getting somewhat closer. Well, we need to be patient and persistent. We still have a long ways to go, and then especially with regard to local share and period conf. Let's just log in. This one is obvious. Guys, and then this one, let's move this one below. And then also allow it to search Hamburg too, because that's also pretty obvious. Not sure what its business is in cache, but we'll see. This one here is also obvious. Actually, all good attributes are obvious. So I need to also take care of this one. I guess I forgot that. And then also for XP. Forgot those the first run in the beginning, where I didn't realize it. Evo address factory. Evo. So you see a pattern coming up here, where it's basically traversing the dir, and I'm just taking a very long road. Evo alarm, same. Evo Cal factory is saying. GNOME contact search provider. Decon search P. And there's more coming, but there's more where that came from. GNOME keyring daemon must do right. to use our own tedious. Ain't that weird? That's probably Czech for writer. Not sure yet, but let's just do first things first. We have here user temp t create. We have GNOME session actually out. GNOME session is actually messing with decoms. Let's go to GNOME session. That's it. Let's place it here and see what it does. So on the door it's actually, I'll just add it here, get attribute, and on the file it's actually right open also, right open. But there's more where that came from. So also that use attempt to get attribute. And that's it for now. Though I know that it's also doing stuff in the user handler. It's done this. GNOME settings daemon wants to do a bunch of stuff. That's a little bit low. Let's just paste that in there. But this one, let's just move this below it, make a little bit more sense out of it. And does stuff to deconf. And thought I already had that deconf stuff, but I guess it didn't. And it wants to search Pulse Audio home doors. I saw that. Use attempt to get attributes. I already had that. Oh, or not. No, I'm not. But it's also obvious. Get attribute, but this is for user empty. Yeah. Back. And that's to be about it. GNOME shell. Some stuff here for GNOME shell. It's a right unlink open and execute. So it's M mapping it. That's a file, so we can ignore that. GNOME shell calendar. G shell cal d. Right in there. And then we have IAM settings, actually removing and so forth and so forth. So after this run, I'll stop because it keeps going and going and going, and we need to take a break. Stretch our muscles. TPMC. TR store. And this is with regard to deconf, so I'll just paste it in here and adjust. So the dir right at 9. And file create. Basically all these suckers need to create that deconf file. Alright, so this is it. Save and exit. So I build this, and then this if it builds installs, then just take a break. Move log out. Clear, kill our processes, clear. Remove the temp stuff here. And do one more out search for 4.8. This looks reasonable. Okay, so we'll basically leave it here.